For the longest time, people have asked me, why don't I own a Minecraft server? And the answer I'd always give them is that they'd just destroy it due to my channel mostly focusing on the topic of the Anarchy server, 2b2t. That server is filled with countless hackers, griefers, and some of the most toxic Minecraft players in existence. With those kind of people joining, it would be destroyed in no time, whether that's by lagging, DDoSing, crashing, or backdooring the server. But then I had a thought, what if that's actually the intention? To see how long the server lasts before you guys literally destroy it. And if it somehow stays up, what would it be like to be the admin of an Anarchy server? So that's what I did. I started a Minecraft Anarchy server. No rules, no bans. Let's see what it took to get this thing running and what major events have happened so far. Now it may first appear that starting a new Minecraft server is a pretty simple feat. All you have to do is download the latest version of Paper Spigot, install and configure a few plugins, and you'll be good to go. But let's just say it was not that simple. At all. First of all, I couldn't use the latest version of Minecraft because it would just be much too unstable for an Anarchy server. So I had to go with version 1.12.2. And also, it turned out that my extra PC I had lying around would not be powerful enough for running a huge Anarchy server. But luckily, I had a friend who knew a guy who was willing to host a server for me. And by the way, thanks so much to these people for making that possible. Now that I had the hardware, it was time to set up the plugins. I had a list of commands that I wanted to be on the server, and we did easily get those working, along with some other plugins like permissions, anti-cheat, and server statistics. But we were still missing one very important thing, a server queue. Now don't even get me started. Trying to find a properly working queue plugin was like trying to find a needle in a haystack. It was impossible, and it's not like we couldn't have a queue. We needed it, because if I were to announce the server, players left and right would be joining and we would hit the player cap in no time. So we tried using a queue plugin that seemed pretty simple in theory, but ended up functioning horribly in practice. If the server got full, you would see a message saying that you were in queue. But to keep your place in line, you had to reconnect every few seconds. Imagine not having a hacked client auto-reconnect for you. This was a terrible system, so we quickly sought other options. So there's these queue plugins that will actually put you into a separate server while you waited to get on the main server, just like 2b2t. Perfect. This was exactly what we needed. So we installed the first one we could find and... what? The server is full? Isn't that what the queue plugin was designed to prevent? Well, maybe the plugin is broken. Let's try another. And... same message. We double-checked all the settings with bungee cord, but we still weren't able to get any of them to work. So we flocked to Fiverr of all places to see if we can hire someone to make a new queue plugin for us. $25 and 2 weeks later gave us a plugin that didn't even work. It was so bad that it wouldn't even show up in the plugin list. We asked for him to fix it, but he instead canceled the order. Now it doesn't end here. Another friend of mine contacted a guy that had a lot of history coding Spigot plugins, and that for $10, he would make a queue plugin for us. So we bought it, and... same issue. We tried contacting the developer again, but he refused to get into voice chat with us so we can diagnose the problem. After many messages, he ended up ghosting us. Oof. Now after all of this madness, we finally saw a light at the end of the tunnel. We found yet another queue plugin that cost $5 that worked without that dreaded error message. There were also a few issues with that plugin too, but it ended up working fine enough. After all the plugins were configured, the server was ready to open. But how was I going to announce it? I was thinking maybe pinging everyone in the Discord, or making a Twitter post, but that's just too basic. Instead, I decided to do the unthinkable. If you've been subscribed to the channel for a while now, you guys probably remember my server crashing streams, where we would get as many people to join a server as possible to hopefully crash it, just for fun. Well, I had the idea to do one of those streams as I would normally do it, but at the end of the stream, when I had almost 3,000 people watching, I would release the IP to the server. And I did. And we messed up one very crucial thing. The server would only allow one person online every 15 seconds. Not per IP like we thought, but for everyone. This ended up being a disaster, and almost nobody, including myself, was able to get on. So we quickly fixed that setting, and the server started to flood with new players. The TPS was surprisingly high until... oof. That's no good. Turns out that people were starting to load a lot of new chunks, which really destroys server performance. Also, our anti-spam plugin was absolutely no help to the many bots spamming complete garbage. Then, the unthinkable happened. Our server got backdoored in just under 24 hours of the server being open. First, a guy was caught using WorldEdit on the queue server. Crazy enough, This was caught on video by a Twitch streamer, but it got even worse. He ended up banning literally everyone on the server, and during this whole ordeal, I was away, so I could literally do nothing. Thankfully, the people that helped me start the server handled the situation by removing the backdoor access, unbanning all the players, and patching the exploit. Wow, now isn't that a lot to happen within 24 hours? Imagine what else is bound to happen in the coming days, and I'll be sure to keep you guys updated on everything. Now before I go, I want to answer a few potential questions you guys may have, with the first being, how long will you keep the server up? Well, the plan is to keep the server up for around a month under my control. Once that month has passed, I'm gonna hand it off to the guy who's hosting the server for me, and let him do whatever he wants with it, which could include keeping it online, which is the most likely scenario. Now this could certainly change as time goes on, but for now, that's the plan. Another potential question may be, what about 2B2T or SMP Earth? Are you going to abandon those servers? Absolutely not. My server is not intended to replace the content on those servers for the long term. This is purely a trial of stepping into the shoes of Housemaster, and seeing what running an Anarchy server is really like. If you guys have any more questions about the server or anything related, be sure to leave a comment down below, or join my Discord server where I have a channel set up just for all the talk about the server. Oh, and here's the IP if you want to give it a try. Anyways, that's all for now. I'll see you all again soon.